First-person games are one of the most popular game types, which in this video we will teach you how to manage and control camera in first-person games. Create a 3D object and name it player. To change player color, create a material. Change its color to red, for example, then drag material to player. Because this is a first-person game, the camera should display the game from the eyes of player. So make the camera child of player and reset its position. Move the camera a little higher till it stays on the player's head. In first step, we want when we drag mouse to left side, the player looks to left side. And when we drag mouse to right side, player looks to the right side. So we only need to change Y of rotation section. It means you only need to turn player to the left and right. Open the script, up here define a float called mouse X. You need moving speed of mouse in X axis. So write in update mouse X equals to input.getAxis, write in parentheses in double quotation, mouse X times speed for example 100 multiplied by time.deltaTime. This line calculates the moving speed of mouse in time unit, which if you want to increase the mouse speed, only increase 100. Now you have the mouse speed. Just remains player turning. So up here define a transform called body. Write in update body.rotate and in parentheses write vector3.up and mouse x. To check if it works, drag the code to camera, then drag player to define a transform means body. Now press play. You can see with moving the mouse to the left and right, the player looks at the left and right. I separate the game tab from the scene till you understand better. Look, when I move the mouse, the player turns. Now what if you want the player looks at the up and down? This time you don't need to turn the player to up and down, only the camera should turn. So open the code, define a new float called mouse Y, do what you did for mouse X, for mouse Y too. Define a new transform to take the player's head or camera. Only instead of mouse X, write mouse Y, instead of body, write head, and instead of vector3.up, write vector3.left. Before play, drag the camera to transform field of head. Now press play, you can look to any direction you want, left, right, up and down. There is a point here, looking up and down should have a limit, so that the player's head or camera cannot go above or below a certain limit. So you have to limit the rotation of the camera up and down, which is called clamping. Here is a place to tank brackets. There are several ways to limit camera rotation, but I recommend using the method I use. I'm going to tell you a weird code. Remove last part of code which was related to rotation of the camera. Up here define a new float called for example angle. Minus equal angle to mouse Y. Below it write angle equals to Mathf.Clamp, then in parentheses write angle and limit angle. For example negative 90 and positive 90. Now you only need equal x of camera rotation to this angle. So write head dot local rotation equals to quaternion dot Euler. In parentheses write angle and 0, 0. After play you can look any direction you want. And it is limited between negative 90 and positive 90 from up and down. Which I think it's a little too high. Look at x of rotation. It will be more suitable if it gets reduced a bit. For example between negative 30 and positive 45 degrees is okay. Next job is to disappear the mouse cursor after play. Only in a start, write cursor.lockState equals to cursorLockMode.locked. Now as soon as you play, if you click on game tab, the mouse cursor disappears. You can look at any direction you want. If your job was finished and you want the cursor displays, press escape on keyboard. Don't forget like and subscribe us.